Welcome to the session. In this session, we will discuss a question which says that prove that the representative points of the complex numbers 1 minus iota, 2 plus iota, 4 plus 5 iota are collinear. Also draw the graph. Now before starting the solution of this question, we should know some results. First is, if the points P, Q and R are collinear, that is P, Q and R are collinear, then PQ plus QR is equal to PR. Second is, if Z1 and Z2 are complex numbers of two points A and B on the either plane, then the distance between them is given by AB, which is equal to modulus of Z1 minus Z2. Third is, for a complex number Z, which is equal to A plus B iota, where A and B belongs to the set of real numbers, modulus of Z is equal to modulus of A plus B iota, which is equal to square root of A square plus B square. Now these results will work out as a key idea for solving out this question. Now we will start with the solution. Now in this question, these complex numbers are given to us. Now let the points P, Q and R represent the complex numbers 1 minus iota, 2 plus iota and 4 plus 5 iota respectively. Then by using this result, which is given in the key idea, now the distance PQ will be equal to modulus of 1 minus iota the whole minus 2 plus iota the whole. As this is represented by P and this is represented by Q. Now this will be equal to modulus of 1 minus iota minus 2 minus iota, which is further equal to modulus of minus 1 minus 2 iota. Now using this result, which is given in the key idea, here A is equal to minus 1 and B is equal to minus 2. So this will be equal to, that is modulus of minus 1 minus 2 iota will be equal to square root of A square plus B square, which will be equal to minus 1 square plus minus 2 square, which is equal to square root of 1 plus 4, which is equal to root 5. Now we will find the distance QR. Now this number is represented by Q and this is represented by R. Now the distance QR will be equal to modulus of 2 plus iota the whole minus 4 plus 5 iota the whole, which is equal to modulus of 2 plus iota minus 4 minus 5 iota, which is further equal to modulus of minus 2 minus 4 iota. Now this will be equal to square root of A square plus B square, Now A here is minus 2 and B here is minus 4. So this will be equal to square root of minus 2 squared plus minus 4 squared. And this is equal to square root of 4 plus 16, which is further equal to root 20, and this is equal to 2 root 5. Now this number is represented by P and this by R. Now the distance PR will be equal to modulus of 1 minus iota the whole minus 4 plus 5 iota the whole. This is equal to modulus of 1 minus iota minus 4 minus 5 iota, which is further equal to modulus of minus 3 minus 6 iota. Now here A is equal to minus 3 and B is equal to minus 6. So this will be equal to square root of A square, which is minus 3 square, plus B square, which is minus 6 square. Now this is equal to square root of 9 plus 36, which is equal to root 45, which is further equal to 3 root 5. Therefore, distance PR is equal to 3 root 5. Now this is QR and this is PQ. Now using the first result, which is given in the key idea, now PQ plus QR is equal to root 5, that is PQ, which is equal to root 5, plus QR, which is equal to 2 root 5, and this is equal to 3 root 5. Now PR is also 3 root 5. And PQ plus QR is also 3 root 5. Therefore, PQ plus QR is equal to PR is equal to 3 root 5. Hence, the points P, Q and R are collinear. Now we have to draw a graph for this. Now, we know that the complex number z is equal to x plus y iota is defined by the ordered pair x, y of real numbers x and y. Now here, the complex number 1 minus iota represents the point P 1 minus 1. As x is 1 here and y is equal to minus 1, so this complex number is defined by the ordered pair 1 minus 1. And the complex number 2 plus iota represents the point q 2 1. Also, the complex number 4 plus 5 iota represents the point R 4, 5. Now let us plot these points on the graph. So we have plotted all these points on the graph. Now by drawing all the three points, you can see that all the three points are lying on the same straight line. Therefore, P, Q and R are collinear points. So this is the solution of the given question, and that's all for this session. Hope you all have enjoyed the session.